stay up line for about 35 minutes. And the sun sets around 8:10. So we're going to fly for about 35, 40 minutes. And head on back. With all this flood going on and all these roads closed, it's a fairly good distance for me to get back home. David, that far. So we're going to go on out here and enjoy the rest of the evening. Tomorrow the weather's going to start dropping back down to the 50s. And the storms are coming in, so it could be the last day for a while. I'm going to head landed and put a jacket on. It's a little chilly. Still a little bouncy out here. Going into the wind. The gust up high, up to 500, 600, 700 feet, 1,000 feet. Gust is supposed to be about 4. It calmed down a little bit more here. So with all the storms and everything moving through, you normally get a mixed bag of wind, so. About 5,600 RPM. A little bouncy. Really nice and green and pretty out here. I haven't smelt any barbecue grills yet today. The olive bushes are starting to bloom. And I'll tell you what, that's one of the sweetest smelling smells. It just covers the air. A lot of places to land over there. Big parking lot. Top of the roof. This is the old Longaberger showcase over here. People come all over, used to come here and fly fast. There's the apple in the basket. Boy, you gotta watch those power lines close. This place is abandoned. There's nothing over here now. Still maintain it, cut the grass and everything, but really nothing going on. there's some good places to land down there. Go with the wind here, so it ought to pick up a little bit. Lean over to the right, do a little weight shift here. We've been flying for about 32 minutes, and we're almost back to the LZ. LZ is right out to the right. Now,